In this video, we will talk about 5 important tips, you know, which will help you to improve your C# debugging skills using Visual Studio. Now, the sole purpose of making this video was, we saw that many of the .NET developers are not exploiting the Visual Studio debugging to a great extent. So from these 5 techniques, we have seen that, you know, developers use maximum to maximum 2 techniques, okay, or maximum 3 techniques, we'll say. So, you know, after looking at this video, we are sure that, you know, your debugging skills will be improved to a great extent and you know, you would be able to find defects in a better manner. Now, before we get into these 5 tips practically, let's first try to understand what exactly is debugging. Now, debugging is nothing but it's a process, you know, or I'll say software debugging is nothing but it's a process, you know, wherein the developer would like to go and find a defect of a program, or probably he would like to go and remove a defect in a program. Now, in order to remove a defect in a program, what he would like to do is he would like to go and see step by step how the program flow is executing. So you'd like to say, okay, which methods are executing, and he would like to sequentially see them, you know, how the program flow is moving. And while the program flow is moving, he would like to see that how the data is set. So for example, if there is a variable or if there is some kind of object, you know, he would like to see that what is the data in those objects and variables. So in short sentence, you know, debugging is nothing but, you know, wherein a developer goes and tries to go step by step and see that how the program flow is executed. In order to understand the debugging techniques practically, I have taken up a simple sample here. In this sample, this actually is a console application, and in this console application we have 2 functions. One is function 1 and the other one is function 2, and both of these functions are called, you know, from the main entry point of the program, that is static void main. Also in this application I have a simple variable here called as a string variable here called as where am I, and this variable is set you know, to I am in function 1 when he actually goes through function 1, and it is set to I am in function 2, you know, when he is in function 2. Okay, so we're going to take this sample as our learning point, and we'll see all the 5 important tips, you know, which will help us to increase our debugging skills, you know, from the Visual Studio debugging perspective. Now, first thing first, in order to put a debug point, what you will do is you will go into the line where you want the program to halt, and from there onwards you want to go and see step by step how the program executes. So for example, here I would like that the program should halt at this execution point, that is function 1, and from there onwards I would like to go step by step and see how the program flow actually happens. So in order to put a debug point, you need to click at the left side bar. You can see that there's a left side bar here, and you're going to click on that. So once you click on that, what happens is it actually highlights it with a brown color, stating that, you know, whenever this program executes, it's going to go and halt at this point, and from that point onwards you can actually go and debug line by line, you know, how your program is exactly executing. So let me go and run this program here and let's see how the debugging works. So the first thing you will see over here is that the time you do F5, right, it has come in and it has halted to that line, you know, where you put the debug point, and you can see that the currently wherever the program is executing, it is marked with the yellow color. So tip number 1, if you want to go and see the program execution line by line, so what you will do is you'll go at the top here, and you can see that there are 3 signs here, you know, step into, step over, and step out. So we should click on this middle icon. So the time I click on this middle icon, you can see that it moves from function 1 to function 2. Again, if I click onto this step over icon again, you know, it actually goes from function 2 and it tries to execute, you know, exit out of the static void main. So if you want to go line by line execution, you know, if you want to just step line by line, you're going to use the step over icon, which is there on the Visual Studio toolbar here. Tip number 2. Now let me take this debug point from here and the execution from here, and just let me go and move back. Okay, now, you know, the step over function is good, you know, it helps you to execute line by line. But sometimes what happens is you can see that we have 2 functions here, function 1 and function 2. So I don't want to do a step into, you know, I actually want to go inside the function 1 and I would like to know what's happening there. So if you want to go inside the function, then you're going to use step into, that is the first icon, you know, from one of those three icons. Okay, so I'm going to click on this step into. So you can see now, the time I clicked on step into, it actually went inside the function one. So again, I can start using step over. I come out here again. If I want to go inside function two, what's happening? Then I will again use step into. So the time I click on step into, you can see again it is going inside the function. So step over, if you want to go line by line. Step into, if you want to go inside a function and investigate more, you know, what's happening inside the function, then you will use the step into icon. Tip number three. Let me just come out from here. Now let's say, you know, you are on function one. You do a step into and you go inside the function one. Okay. Now, you know, let's say that, you know, you are actually going to execute function one, you know, but you are not interested in executing all the lines of code, you know, inside function one. You want to just come out and you want to go and halt at function two. So in other words, what you want to do is, you are now, your debug point is currently on function one, it's going to execute, but you are not interested in executing this line of code. You want to just come out and you want to just come to function two line. So for that, what you'll do is, you're going to use the step out. Step out means, you know, if you are inside a function or a method, and from there you want to just skip and come out to the next line after the method, you know, from where the method was called, you're going to use step out. In other words, for instance, over here, the function one was called from static void main. So if I do a step out from here, from this position, it will actually come back and halt here at function two. So let me do that. Let me just click on step out and just watch out how the debugging point moves out. So I'm going to do a step out here, and you can see it has actually come out and it has actually come to function two. So it did not execute this line of code. Again, let's do this practical. Again, let me step into function two. I'm not interested in executing this line. So if I do a step out, you can see again I'm at function two. And if I just again click on step over, it actually comes out. So in other words, the step out function you will use, you know, when you want, you know, to not execute all the lines of code from a function, and you would like to just go back and to the next point, you know, from where the caller has called that function. So we covered three important tips till now. First one, step over, step by step. Step into, if you want to go inside a function while debugging. And step out, if you want to exit out of the function and you would like to come to the next line of code, you know, from where the caller has called. Tip number four. Now, you know, as we are doing debugging, we would also like to see the values of our variables. For example, here we have a variable called where am I. And I would like to see, you know, what exactly is the value of the variable currently. Okay. So let me do first a step into. Let me come over here. Okay. And let me just execute this line here. So currently, I would like to know, you know, what is there in this where am I variable. So in order to see the value, just move your mouse tooltip there, and you can see that the value is seen. I am in function one. So that's the value. If you want to see this value in a very quick manner, select the variable, right click, and say quick watch. If you do a quick watch here, it actually shows you the value here quickly, and you can close the window and see the value and then move ahead again with your debugging. So one is, you can just move your tooltip and find the value, but in case sometimes you have complicated objects, then the moving the tooltip does not work. So select that, right click, and say quick watch, and you can see in the quick watch window the value of the variable. Right now, sometimes what happens is, you know, this quick watch window is good, you know, it shows us the value, but, you know, I would like to maintain a list, you know, where at the left hand side or somewhere, you know, I would like to see while debugging the program what currently the value is going on. Here what's happening is, I need to select it and do a quick watch, and then I see in the in the window. What I would like to do is, when I'm debugging, I would like to see this or debug this variable data at side by side. So for that, we have something called as the add watch. So in order to see the running list of my data, right, I can use something called as the add watch. So in other words, let me again go to function one. Let me select this where am I variable, and let me do a add watch. Now the time I do a add watch, you can see that now this variable has, you know, has been added to my watch list. In other words, as I do debugging, I'm going to delete some old watch variables here. So now as I'm debugging, for example, let me go inside function one, right? So the value of where am I is function one currently. Let me go inside function two. And the time I go inside function two, you can see the value of the variable is changing. So quick watch is used, you know, when you want to quickly see the variable or data and the value and just close it. And add watch is used, you know, when you want to actually on runtime or while you're debugging continuously, you'd like to see the value in a watch list so that you can debug in a better manner. So we covered four tips. First tip number one, use step over to go line by line. Step into, tip number two, step into, go inside a function. Step out, come outside a function, and then see the variables by using quick watch, add watch, and the tooltip. Tip number five. Now, this fifth tip, you know, is the best thing, you know, what is there in Visual Studio in terms of debugging. The first thing is, you know, this tip or this debugging feature is available only in Visual Studio 2010. It is not available in Visual Studio 2005 or in 2008. This tip is called as intellitrace. Okay, so now let me run this application again, and I have put a debug point there, and I am currently on function one line. Okay, and let's say I click into step into, I go inside step, you know, function one, and currently my variable is set to nothing. I set it to I am in function one. Then I come out, I also execute function two. Okay, and I set this variable where am I to function 2 now. And now I'm going to just exit out of function 2. Okay, just I'm at the verge, you know, where I'm going to exit out. But suddenly I feel that, you know, I would like to go and rewind back my debug. And I would like to see, you know, what happened in function 1. What was the variable set? You know, so I would like to rewind back and restart again. And that's where we use IntelliTrace. Now the first thing is we need to go and enable IntelliTrace. So to enable IntelliTrace, click on Tools, Options. Go to the IntelliTrace tab, click on General, and click the option IntelliTrace Events and Call Information, so that it collects all the call information and helps you to you know, go and rewind your debug, you know, or it helps you to rewind and restart, you know, from a certain point you're debugging. Now you can see over here, you know, there's a small sentence here saying it collects call information which can degrade application performance. So in other words, what, you know, that's why IntelliTrace is disabled by default, because, you know, when we enable IntelliTrace, it has to capture a lot of history of your debugging, right? So that's why the debugging becomes a bit slower. So by default, you know, this option is selected, that is IntelliTrace events only. But currently we are interested in the IntelliTrace events and call information. So we have checked this checkbox, this option button. So now let's click on cancel and let's go back to our debugging. Now the first thing, if you have enabled IntelliTrace, you should see a rewind and a forward button here, you can see at the left hand side. So in order to step back in debugging, or you, if you want to go back and restart, you know from the previous debug point, you can see that there is a back button here. So click on this. So once you click on this, you'll see that, you know, it has the debug line was on this curly brackets. Now it has moved to this line, that is where am I in function 2. Again, if you click, it will again go to the next curly bracket. If I again hit on this, you know, it will actually go to function 1. You can click on this, so you can see that it's now moving towards function 1. Okay, in the same way, if I want to know if I want to step ahead, you know, I can always go and use this go to next call button here. And if I want to go and step into a function, right, I can use this. So for example, if I use this, right, it actually goes to function 2, right? If I use this, it goes to function 1. But what if I want to go inside function 1, then I can use this step in function here. So if I use this, it actually goes inside the function 1, right? Now, also, what about the variables? You know, that is again more interesting to understand, okay? Okay, now before I go towards the variables, now let's say you are over here and you want to start your debugging from here. So you can go and now start clicking on the debug here and then start debugging from here again, okay? So you can see now you have again, you know, restarted your debugging, right? So IntelliTrace, you know, basically helps you to rewind, you know, or it helps you to see the history of what you're debugged. And second, you know, it also helps you to move back and start your debugging from a certain point again. Okay. Now, one of the other expectation, you know, as a developer, I would have from IntelliTrace is that whenever I go and rewind back, right, or whenever I'm doing a historical debugging, I would also like to know, you know, at that moment, what was my variable data. So for example, let's say I go back to function one, I go back again to function one. And if I move my mouse on this, where am I,
I should see over here saying that, you know, the value is I am in function 1, because now at this moment my history debug point is on function 1. But if I move my mouse here, you can see that it has said IntelliTrace data has not been collected. And that is by default the behavior of IntelliTrace. You know, because IntelliTrace is a heavy debugging thing, right? By default, everything is not collected here, right? So if you want to see the variables also IntelliTraced, or if you want to see the history of debugging of the variable data, you need to ensure that, you know, this data is a part of your debug window or of your ad watch or of your quick watch window. Okay, so let me stop this here and let me go and again start debugging. But this time what I'll do is, you know, before I start debugging, I would like to go and add this where am I variable to a ad watch window. So let me just go and start debugging here. Let me click on where am I and let me just add it to my ad watch window. So now, you know, this where am I variable is added to my ad watch window. Now the historical, the IntelliTrace debugger would, or the IntelliTrace will capture my history of the debugging, the debugged values. So let me just go and start debugging here. So let me just click on step into, go into function 1, go into the where am I function, go to function 2, again go to and set the where am I function. Okay. Now I am on function 2 and I would like to rewind back and go to this function 1 and I would like to see here value as I am in function 1. Okay. So let me just click on rewind. Again, let me just click on rewind. Let me just go back one by one. Let me go back to function 1. Okay. Now let me see my variable. So if I go inside this step, this function 1, and let me just go to the next call, to the next call. Okay. Now after this call, I would like to see what kind of data where am I was having. And if you move your mouse, now you will see that it is actually tracking your historical debug data. Okay. So, in other words, if you want even the variables, even the local variables or any variables to also be tracked into IntelliTrace, you have to ensure that it is a part of at least the AdWatch window, or else, you know, the data will not be collected. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. So in this video, we talked about 5 important tips, you know, which will enhance your debugging skills. So first 3, you know, was step over, step into, second tip, step out, the third tip. Then the quick watch and the ad watch window, the fourth tip, and the fifth tip was historical debugging, that is IntelliTrace. So I hope that you enjoyed this video, and you know, keep watching questmon.com, and I hope that you grow in terms of knowledge in .NET and Visual Studio. Thank you very much. Now whatever video you have seen, right, is just a glimpse of what we have done. So in case you are interested in our video package, you can go to our site, that is www.questmon.com. You can call on this number and you can ask the complete DVD package what we have. So in this DVD package what we have done is basically we have covered almost everything what a .NET developer wants. So right from basics of ASP.NET, object-oriented programming, SQL Server, to new technologies like WCF, Silverlight, Link, Azure, Entity Framework. We also have UML, architecture, estimation, project management. There is a complete invoicing project end-to-end which is covered, so that you can get a better feel of how to actually create projects in a systematic manner. We have covered server products, you know, both for SharePoint 2007 as well as for 2010. We have a lot of best practices video on SQL Server, etc. So this complete package, you know, you can get from www.questmon.com if you're interested, and you can call on this number and you can ask for the rates. It's a very decent rate what we have. In the same way. You know, as compared to the videos, we also have one more product with us, that is our interview question books. So we have different kinds of interview question books, you know, right from .NET interview questions to SQL Server interview questions, SharePoint interview questions, BizTalk interview questions, etc. So in case you are interested in the books part, you can call on these numbers as per your location. So you can see these numbers on the board at this moment. So I hope that you keep enjoying the videos, you keep seeing our site, and I hope that you gain more knowledge. Thank you very much.